there's got to be some serious respect that must be given to musicians. I mean, we've gone years and years knocking our heads against the wall.
He was one of the best fathers I've seen. I mean, he loves his children, all of his children, you know what I mean?
I remember him the dad. I remember him the father.
He grew up in the rural areas, herding the goats and stuff like that. He was just by himself. And now, in the rural areas where he was, and he was colored, right? And he was mixing with all these black people. It was just him and all these black people, you know what I mean?
The man looked close to a white man with dreadlocks. But he could speak better Shona and Ndebele than most black people I know.
Coming from a mixed race background, growing up in a rural village amongst his extended black family, definitely had a direct impact on how we viewed the political situation.
As far as my father was concerned, it wasn't the color of his skin. It was more about his roots and how he felt on the inside and how what culture drove him.
I know that he never really considered himself to be mixed race. He always wanted to be black.
So I'm not alone, so I don't think because that is a lesser business than any other business that exists in this country. So please, people must start to consider that. This is serious business, man.
He believed that the land belonged to the people. And when I say people, I don't just mean black people, I mean colored people as well.
He was an active participant in reclaiming land back according to the historical injustices that were perpetrated on the original landowners.
I mean, I come from a place, I come from Berenba, where a man owns 300 kilometers square. And my mother and uncles and them are all squashed up in this, you know, sandy place. And look, just give us some of the land that you have. And
when you are different, you stick out. When you stick out, you become a target. And the independent media in Zimbabwe, I think unfairly, characterized Andy Brown's efforts either as a misguided, either as a unprincipled, and in some instances even as being a useful tool of the regime.
They pick you up to bring you down. So, because bad news sells.
It's a sad story. Sad story.
It was evident that a lot had changed.
You know, we go through our teething problems and everything. I know everything is gonna be okay eventually, but give the people land. You know, don't take too much share.
You must stand for something. I mean, you cannot walk around believing in nothing. And it's hard. It's hard to do that. It was hard, but he did it.
So some of the music we play is generally politics, socio-economic.
The man was talented. He was gifted. He changed Zimbabwean music into his own form of understanding of what music is. You know, he created his own sound, his own unique sound, which was appreciated throughout this country. And the reason why I think he was not recognized for it can only be down to racism and prejudice.
No, I don't have one memory of him receiving an award.
I am a son of a daughter of the soil. I was born in the green hills of Mberengwa. I come from Guruve. I come from the dusty soil of Whitebridge. I come from the flowing river of the Zambezi. This is my home, Zimbabwe, Africa.
Thank you, for every greatness that you brought into the world, because there were many. Maybe the whole world didn't know, but I know.
We had our times, we had our good times, we had our bad times, but I just want to say to my brother, rest in peace.
I don't know if he ever knew peace, but I hope he has it now. Nanda kasinga shnuri mava kumana.